Today we have chemistry topic, separation techniques, according to the scheme of work. So we have to analyze all the methods that are involved in these separation techniques. But the first and foremost, what is this separation techniques, if I may ask? Can any of you give me the definition of separation techniques? Okay, all right. Separation techniques involve the process whereby you separate different constituents and substances from each other using different methods. Now, in separation techniques, we have about 15 methods of separation techniques. We have number one, sieving. We have number two, magnetization. We have number three, distillation. We have number four, crystallization. We have number five, centrifugation. We have number six, chromatography. Then we have number six, fractional distillation. Number seven, fractional distillation. We have number eight, fractional crystallization. We have paper chromatography. And all the other ones. Now, number one, sieving. What is sieving in separation techniques? When you talk about sieving in separation techniques, is a method in the separation techniques which we use to separate a solute of different size, or you can say that it is a method used in the separation of a particle of different size. And what are these particles of different size? When you talk about a substance that is made up of a solid substance, for example, if you see a woman that is sieving garri, for example, you will see that after the sieving, there are lower particles that will enter into the bowl, while some other solid particle or higher particle will remain on top of the sieve. Now, when you give the diagram, you have what to call the sieve, which is the material or the instrument that you use to sieve the garri. Why the particle that descend or that enter into the bowl is a filtrate. Why you have the other one on top. So that process which you separate between the solid high particle or bigger particle from the small particle is what to call sieving. And that is the method used in the separation techniques of sieving. Now we have number two, magnetization. What is this magnetization? Magnetization is the process whereby you separate a metal from non-metals. For example, you use what to call magnets. And with a magnet, you can separate between metals and non-metals. For example, when you see somebody that was looking for something on the ground, maybe you are a mechanic or you are any electrical engineering, and if you use magnet, maybe one of the pin, call it office pin or call it one of the pin, fall on the ground. You can use a magnet to separate between the magnet, the metals and non-metals. So that is a separation technique. Now the process whereby the magnet select the metals and leave non-metals, that is magnetization. Now we have number three, distillation process. What is this distillation process? A distillation process is a process which we use in a separation technique to recover a solvent from a solution. To recover what? A solvent from a solution. What is this solvent in a solution? We have solutes plus solution plus solvent to give me equals to what? Solution. A solute plus solvent to give me solution. Now this solute can become sugar, for example. Now we have another one, solvent, as water. So water, sugar plus water will give me a solution. Now the method I recover a solvent from a solution. Now what is this solvent? A solvent is a water. Why we have a solute inside, which is sugar, is the missing of two of them is what we call a solution. So now distillation process say, how do I recover a solvent from a solution? Now that is distillation process. And this process can is carried out by heating of this mixture, which is a solution. And when you heat it, evaporation will take place and there will be a loss of water remaining, leaving the solute, which is sugar, inside. And that is what we call distillation process. And by so process, you have separate between a solute and a solvent. And that is distillation. Now we have another one which we call crystallization. Crystallization. A crystallization process is also a one of the method, a very important method used in separation techniques. And what is this crystallization? Crystallization involves whereby you separate an immiscible solvent. An immiscible solvent, example, kerosene and water cannot mix together. They are immiscible. And because of that, the ability or the process which you separate between kerosene and water become what we call crystallization. So we have another one, centrifugation. What is centrifugation? A centrifugation is the process whereby you separate a plasma with its blood, or you separate a lower density of a substance from a higher density. Let me just give you an example of what centrifugation is all about. When you put a blood inside test tube and put it into what we call the centrifugal machine, now you are going to see when you plug on or when you put on the centrifugal machine, then you begin to turn. As it turns, what you are going to see? You are going to see a plasma on top while you are going to see the blood down. That is to say that the density of the plasma is lower and while the density of the blood is higher. And that's what made the blood to settle at the bottom of the test tube. Why? That of plasma is on top. So you have separated between the plasma and the blood. That is what we call centrifugation. So it's a very important separation technique use. So we have another one, what we call chromatography. A chromatography is the process whereby you use an advantage of the speediness of the substance that are involved. For example, if I have something like kerosene and have something like oil, if I bring what we call filter paper, which we all know, the filter paper, if I put a drop of red oil on a filter paper and put a drop of kerosene on a filter paper, which of them will first of all spread? Now you will believe with me that kerosene will first spread in the filter paper before the red oil. So because of that, you are now separating, taking the advantage of this substance, which is kerosene and red oil. So that is separation techniques. You are taking the advantage of the substance that are involved. Now we have what we call fractional distillation as number 7. What is this fractional distillation? Fractional distillation is the process whereby you separate a mixture immiscible with using what we call their boiling points. Their boiling point. What is this their boiling point? For example, if I have kerosene or ethanol, let me have ethanol, for example, and water. When I mix two of them together, and we all know that ethanol and water cannot mix together. Now, if I want to separate two of them, I have to use their boiling point. And what is this their boiling point? Like boiling point of ethanol is 78 degrees centigrade. Why the boiling point of water is 100 degrees centigrade? Now, if I may ask, which of them will first boil? Or which of them will boil first? So, if you believe to me, you will find out that 78 and 100. So 78 degrees centigrade will first of all boil before the 100 degrees centigrade. Now, after the boiling of this one, it will begin to evaporate because it has boiled before 100 degrees centigrade. So as it is evaporating, leaving water inside it. Now, by that process, you can now collect ethanol first, leaving the water there, using their boiling point as the advantage. So that is the separation technique, which is fractional distillation. So, all right, now we also have paper chromatography as one of the separation techniques. What is this paper chromatography? A paper chromatography is when you use what we call an absorbent medium. That is the ability to absorb. That is paper chromatography. We have ethanol, we have ethyl ethanoate, we have water and other ones. Now when you use in this paper chromatography, if you want to check their ability to separate, now ethanol with water, which one will separate first compared to ethyl ethanoate and water? Now what is ethyl ethanoate? Ethyl ethanoate is also known as ester that has a very high molecule of a compound. Now this their molecule make it more larger, and because of that they will find it difficult to absorb first because they have a large molecule. Why water is all about two elements, the hydrogen and the oxygen. Why ethanol is the carbon, the hydrogen and also oxygen. Now you can find out now that water and ethanol can easily absorb more than that ethyl ethanoate. So this makes it the separation techniques, paper chromatography. We have another one, precipitation. What is precipitation? A precipitation is also one of the separation techniques which use the difference in their solubility. What is solubility? Solubility is an ability of any substance to dissolve in water. An ability of them to dissolve in water is what we call solubility. And how does this precipitation is a separation technique? Because different substance or different compound dissolve in different time. The different, because of the substance that are made up of, we have example sodium chloride, for example, plus silver trioxonitrate. These are the two substances. When you mix them together, you find out that sodium chloride, which is normal salt that we are using at home, we dissolve first before silver trioxonitrate 5. So because of that, you can separate sodium chloride and silver trioxonitrate 5 using what we call precipitation. This is a separation technique. So you can separate sodium chloride from silver trioxonitrate using their solubility, their ability to dissolve in water. We have another one, separating funnel. We all know separating funnel. So when you place a funnel on top of any gallon or call it any instrument, you will now put a filter on top and filter your water. This is supposed to serve as separation funnel. And using this separating funnel, you find out that some of the residue, which are those particles that remain on top of the filter, while the other one that descend inside the can or that of the gallon is what we call filtrate. So the residue, as you have separated the residue from the filtrate, you have used what we call separating funnel. So that is also another separation technique. Now we have number 12, which we call sublimation. What is sublimation? A sublimation is the process whereby a solid substance evaporates from solid without passing through a liquid medium to a gaseous state. A substance evaporates without passing a liquid medium and evaporate to gaseous state. Example of them is what we call camphor. We all know camphor at home. When you keep a camphor here, you find out that the camphor will be reducing in size. And you've not seen any liquid on the ground where the camphor has melted. So because of that, it becomes a separation technique. Because you can separate, it can move from the solid state to gaseous state. We have finally, the number 13, decantation. Decantation process. A decantation process is also a process which we use to separate a soluble solid from a solvent. Soluble solid from a solvent. When I say a soluble solid, I mean a solid substance that can dissolve in water. For example, pap. We all know pap. Now, pap, when you put pap inside a bowl and put water, probably you may not want to you may not want to use it that day. Then the next day, if you come, you will now bring the bowl. I want to filter the water that is on top of the pap. So by so process, I will not don't want to allow the pap to mix with the water. So by the time that you are separating the water from that of pap, you have made it what we call decantation. You are now decanting the water so that the soluble solid, which is the pap, will not mix with the water. That is decantation process. We can also do it in some of the activities that we do, for example, gare we drink and some other activities. So that is decantation. So the process whereby you separate the water from that of gare, which you are about to take, or from that of the pap, is what we call decantation process. It's a separation technique because you are separating two of them. Now we have what we call column chromatography. What is this column chromatography? A column chromatography is the process whereby you separate a substance or element because of their ionization energy or because of their ability to ionize. That is what we call column chromatography. So we have something like sodium, for example, sodium ion. We have what we call chlorine ion, which is negative. When you mix two of them together, the negative will first of all ionize before the sodium. So this make it what we call column chromatography. We have another one, evaporation process. Evaporation take place every day in our life activities. So what is this evaporation? Evaporation is a process whereby a water from the surface area move in a gaseous form to the atmospheric air. And by that process, you will now find out that it is separating between a solid or any other substance with that of water. And that is evaporation. We have what we call filtration. A filtration is also another separation technique which involve the process whereby you separate a solid substance from a solvent. Example of this solid solvent, we have particles. It's well-soluble particles. And all those particles, they may not descend inside that of filtrate. In that filter, we have the filtrate, we have the residue. Filtration is just like when you talk about filter paper, they're almost the same thing. When you talk about filter paper, you are talking about the funnel that you use. When you talk about filtration, is the process that takes place when you filter two of them. So that is what we call filtration, the process that involves in the separation of soluble particles and that of solvent. And this are the different types of separation techniques that you can use. So if we are to proceed, we have other methods that you can see in these separation techniques. And what are these methods? We are talking about, I need to clean here. We are talking about having the angles which involve in separation techniques, like the changes that occur. And what are these changes? We have a triangle that represents the changes. What are these triangles? We have here as a gaseous state. We have here as a solid state. We have here as liquid state. Then, for a process whereby a solid moves to gas is what we call sublimation. This is a triangle that represents separation techniques also. Now we have what we call sublimation. Now for gas coming back to solid is what we call condensation. Now we have the process whereby a solid moves to liquid state. Process whereby a solid moves to liquid state is what we call melting. Then the process whereby liquid come back to solid state is what we call liquefaction. Then the process whereby liquid to gas is what we call evaporation. evaporation. So these are the things that we have to represent the separation techniques. So we have the gas, we have the solid, the liquid, evaporation, the liquefaction, the melting, condensation, and sublimation, as the case may be. Another topic that will go on under these separation techniques is the elements, the mixture, and the compound.